Well, that's a switch. Welcome back, guys, The Raw Geek here. And yes, there is a switch in a sarcastic way, because we're talking about aliens, and I do talk about aliens fairly regularly, not every week. Maybe not even every month. Maybe it's not that regular after all. Oh well. But as you know, I do like aliens, the Xenomorph universe in general, particularly Aliens, the sequel to Alien from 1979, Aliens, the sequel, 1986. One of the best movies ever, really. Arguably one of the best sequels ever. Now, we know usually sequels aren't always that good, are they? But there's a few notable exceptions, like Terminator 2 is amazing. Better than the first, you could say. And Aliens is amazing. Better than the first, you could say. Of course, the first movies have their own uniqueness, and you can't really beat that. That's what started the series, you know, but there are some really good sequels, and Aliens is one of them. And so I wanted to bring you something I saw a little while back. In fact, I think I saw this a few months ago or more, that this project had started, but now I've seen there's a trailer kind of thing for it and more details about it. And it's basically a project you can back, and it's a documentary. I guess you could call it a fan-made documentary, talking about all the things to do with aliens, you know, behind the scenes, different interviews, things you may not have seen before, basically. And I guess we'll do it this way around. I'll show you the project first, and then I'll show you the trailer, I suppose. I mean, the trailer, I guess, is in here, but we won't write that yet. So, Aliens Expanded is what it's called. Welcome to a new species of documentary. It's raised over $111,000. It's got 839 backers, which is quite a lot of backers. You may have heard of one of the backers if you like alien stuff at all. Alien Theory is a quite big channel with alien stuff, and he's one of the backers. It says, the ultimate companion to James Cameron's Aliens. Back now to receive access to a year of events, plus your name in the credits and exclusive physical rewards. To be honest, that sounds quite good, actually. How much is the back? I wouldn't mind it saying The Raw Geek there somewhere in the credits. That'd be pretty cool, wouldn't it? And you can see it says events begin October 2022, Halloween month, and the physical items ship just a bit of a year later, basically estimated. Okay, fine. Well, the estimations don't always work out too well, but you know, they've got good backing. I'm not denying they would be able to pull this off. I'm sure they could. So in 1986, James Cameron directed In 1986, James Cameron directed one of the greatest sequels of all time. Get rid of that superfluous "the." Taking the characters, action, and design of Ridley Scott's original Alien masterpiece to a new level. And we've been obsessed with it ever since. It is amazing. Now it's time to revisit LV-426 again. This time of a different mission. Welcome to a new species of documentary. You're invited to join an unmissable year-long celebration of James Cameron's epic that includes with the release of Alien Expanded, the most sophisticated and passionate exploration of aliens in the movie. That was quick, wasn't it? Together we will delve deeper than ever before into what makes this film so special, so magical, that we can't help but return to it again and again. I have probably watched this movie 426 times. By the end, you will come to know and love your favourite film even more. These are some bold claims. That's a big statement, bruh. You better back that up. The documentary, Aliens Expanded, will be the ultimate love letter to aliens. Ah, that's cute. The people who made it and the communities who love it. Featuring brand new interviews with the original cast and crew. Oh, that's cool. This will be the most detailed analysis ever made of our favourite film. It's a shame they couldn't speak to Private Hudson, Bill himself, Bill Paxton. I did a video of all his scenes. I say all his scenes. Some had to be clipped out because it got blocked on YouTube, basically. Some of the good scenes as well, like where he goes, why don't you put her in charge? Taking the mick, and a few other good scenes. But most of his amazing scenes, nearly all of them, are in that video, which is really cool. He's a great character in there, in that movie. And so I did that video. So it says here, to ensure our documentary truly reflects the incredible legacy of this beloved epic, we'll also be working closely with the Aliens fan community. You haven't asked me yet. Including interviewing key Aliens influencers. I don't like the word influencers in a way. You know, it's... I find it a bit cringe. Is that what people... I'm not an influencer. Like... I don't know, it just seems a bit weird. Aliens influencers. So what is their job? Their job's to make people like the movie Aliens. Is that their entire... That's their entire being. What do you do for a living? Well, I'm an Aliens influencer. Oh, okay. partnering with top fan communities and encouraging backers to give feedback on the project. By the way, even though I'm having a go at the word influencers there, I wouldn't mind doing something like this full time. If anyone out there wants to scout me, I'm just saying... But I just find it a bit cringe to call it that. The experience during a year-long adventure will enjoy live Q&As with the Aliens cast and crew, regular vidcasts, and many other community events that will take us closer and deeper than ever into the world of Aliens. All told, you'll receive 20 plus hours of Aliens content. Well, that's a lot. And entertainment during production. Oh, okay, so it's all that. Right, fair enough. Plus a documentary, an inclusive sew-on patch. Oh, that's cool. And more physical tiers only at the end of the project. Crowdfunding ends October 1st, so you better get your skates on. So what have we? So should we see? Right, there's lots of stuff. And like I say, I mentioned Alien Theory earlier. You can see it's there. Let's look at the packages. I'm not. You know, you can go to this website. I'll link it down. Oh, that's a really cool picture. Well, is that the front cover of the? That's really cool. That's a cool documentary picture for the DVD or whatever they're doing on. Oh, look. Okay, let's. So they get. So what's this then? Okay, let's look at the packages. So if you back now with $50, you get a copy of the Alien Expanded, plus your all access pass to a year long celebration. So a digital copy, name the credits, soundtrack, ticket to a year long, 20 hours of background. Okay, fair enough. If you do the Blu-ray package for $100, your AAA quality Blu-ray comes with a whole host of physical rewards, plus your all-access pass to our year-long celebration. So you get Blu-ray, posters, sew-on patch, certificate, commemorative mini booklet, your name in the credits. Okay, cool. And then if you do the... so it's just... Is that basically just a t-shirt on top, is it? Expansive case. Yeah, I think it's just literally a t-shirt. Which is it's got that on the t-shirt, which is pretty cool. And associate producer. Now, if you cough up some big bucks, you put in a grand, you get an associate producer credit on IMDb. Poster and movie credits, plus all the other awards. I wish I had $1,000 to just go out that with. Just put my name on IMDb, baby. But I don't. Oh my word, if you're a producer, so there's none of this associate producer nonsense. If you're an actual producer, if you cough up 2.5, you get producer credit, poster and all the other stuff. I mean, this is really cool stuff. Like, it's cool. They're not probably expecting lots of people to do these tiers, but it's cool to include them, and you know, you can be part of history in a way, you know? And executive producer. Okay, now we're nearly director. In a minute, he's going to let you buy the tier that makes you the person that did all this. They did the work, but your name goes there, as though you did all of it, I guess. So, yeah, executive producer, you get executive producer credit, plus we have stuff. So it just goes higher up. Your name, you know, is more important. And producer Q&A, we got nukes, we got knives, sharp sticks. Oh, so here's a bit of a bit better look at this stuff. Confirmed interviewees. This is cool. Yeah. They got some good people involved, definitely. Some key names. So cool. We might as well watch the trailer now, because I've waffled on for a long time. But I just wanted to bring this to you, because it sounds pretty cool, I think. Okay, so it's 4 minutes long, so it's quite a long trailer. But let's have a look. The music's amazing.
Bio readouts are all on the green. Looks like she's alive.
Such good movie.
You're going out there to destroy them, right? Not to study.
That's the plan.
Liar. Ultra Mega Corporation, evil.
Soldiers.
It won't make any difference.
I want this thing to go smooth and by the numbers.
Let's rock!
I say we take off and nuke the entire site from orbit. It's the only way to be sure.
I agree.
Stop your grinning and drop your linen.
Multiple signals!
Coming up the goddamn walls! That's cool. That was terrifying when that first came out like that.
Not a glorious day in the core.
My name is Ian Nathan. I'm the author of Alien Vault, and I'm the writer-director of Aliens Expanded. Aliens Expanded will be the most sophisticated and passionate exploration of aliens ever made.
Five. We're on express elevator to hell.
The reason we come back to aliens again and again is because there's something magical within it. There's something I don't think even Cameron could explain, but we're going to try and find it.
Hmm. All right, gear up. 2 minutes, people.
Just a brilliant film.
It's amazing.
We love it, and we just want to talk about it.
Is this going to be a stand-up fight, sir, or another bug hunt?
There's something universal at the heart of Cameron's filmmaking. He creates characters you love, that you recognize, that you relate to. He creates
themes
within his films, and especially with aliens, that come to the heart of the human experience.
You don't talk much, do you?
We're going to come at it in a new way. We're going to look at the film in a different way. We're going to give it a different energy. This is as much about loving aliens as it is about understanding aliens. We're going to go out and talk about the theories, the in-world stuff, you know, where the creature came from, the biology of aliens. Just go deeper and find something new, something beneath what we already have.
Uh-oh.
So when you watch the film again, the first thing you'll do is turn on Aliens Expanded afterwards to go, oh, yeah.
You want some? Get some.
Yeah, God, great. We are running an ongoing consultation with our backers to ensure that our documentary truly reflects the incredible legacy of this beloved epic.
Magnificent, isn't it?
You'll receive an exclusive invitation to a year-long fan experience, including live cast and crew Q&As, vidcasts, and community events. Then at the end of the project,
it's very clever. That's
receive
very cool.
Your copy of the documentary and other physical rewards, including posters, a sew-on patch, and a certificate, as well as your name in the credits.
That's really cool, that
personal
bit.
And unique memento of your love for aliens.
Yeah, it's clever.
Okay, what do I do?
Okay, I'm on it.
That's really cool, and what I think's good about that is they genuinely seem passionate about it. I don't think they're going, oh, let's try and do something to make a load of money. I don't think they are. It seems to me they just love the movie and the franchise and want to bring something special to people. You can't really have a go at that. You can't complain when people are trying to make new content, you know, even if it's about an old movie, even if it's a documentary, you know. I think that's pretty cool. You know, they were saying there, what is the magic of the movie? I think I have a feeling of what it is. This is my opinion anyway. It's because it's in the future, but a somewhat believable one. You know, you've got this ultra mega corporation, you know, they refer to as the company. It was just Weyland Industries, and obviously Yutani merged, Weyland Yutani. And they basically control everything. And, you know, they're not nice people. They just want more for themselves, less for everyone else. They control the food, they control the pharmaceuticals, they control, you know, weapons. they want to mine stuff throughout the universe, because obviously they, you know, Earth's no longer enough for them, so they've gone out to the universe to mine all that stuff, and they basically control everything, and they are shady. They're very shady, like most, like in real life, you know, some ultra mega corporations, they're not nice people, and, you know, so they control everything, and they think, oh, let's try and get this ultra deadly species, because we want to do our strange Frankenstein experiments with it, and maybe make an army out of these aliens. They're nuts. They are not good people, and they've thrown this group of people, who are pretty much regular nice people. Obviously, you've got the Jarhead type people, you know, the Marines, and they love that sort of stuff. But they have camaraderie, and they're human, and they care about people way more than their bosses. So you've got someone who's just survived an alien on their ship, being found by these people, and they're thrust back into this situation created by their bosses, and they have to fight and come together against a terrifying alien species, so it's got the horror element to it as well, and it's basically human spirit versus evil. Not that some people will say the xenomorphs aren't evil, but you know what I mean, against monsters, both the people who own them, their bosses, and these monsters they're now stuck with on LV-426. And amongst all of that, there's a little girl that's found. And this image sums it up a lot. And one of her lines, you know, she says, "Get away from her, you bitch." It's like, you leave the kids alone. You leave the kids alone, and we're trying to save this kid. And it's just that motherly instinct, that human instinct, of trying to save a defenseless, well, she's pretty resourceful, but, you know, save a child against evil. And it's quintessential. And I think that's what the magic is, because it's got all the fun elements, like the guns, you know, the monsters, you know, the shady conspiracies going on with the corporation, and then it's got nice normal people stuck in there, and it's like, what would you do? It's that type of thing, and I could talk about it for ages. I just think it's an amazing movie, and I think there's so much action in it which makes it brilliant, but there's also there is a deep story underneath it. Does that make sense? It sounds like I'm probably reading too much into it, but that's what it feels like to me. And it's just like it's about the indomitable spirit of being a human. That's what I think it is. But what do you think? Do you think Aliens is a good movie? Do you think this documentary and stuff, this Aliens Expanded project, is pretty good? You should let me know down below. So guys, if you like that, please click like, make sure you subscribe for more videos like this, and I'll see you on the next video. And until then, remember, it's only game over if you let it be. Okay, bye. Guys, if you're still here, you're awesome! But as you are still here, why not check out some of my other videos? Oh, and if you haven't already, please click subscribe. Laters, haters.